Hi, Carrie here from My Quick Bookkeeping. Mohammed asked about how to set up a rate per hour in QuickBooks. So what we're going to do today is set up some different rates for different people, record some time against them, and then invoice them out to a client.
Here we are in the sample company. We go up to the cog where we can select products and services. So what we want to do is we're going to create a new service. And it will be a service. And what will we call it? Mohammed, I'm not too sure what it is that you sell, but we'll just call it an hourly service. And we're going to say yes, that you sell it to your customers, and you sell it for $100. And we're going to put it into, the account services. We'll call it and put it in services. If you have a different account, wherever you want this to appear on the profit and loss is where you would put that to. Now, you have the choice here of marking that $100 to include tax, or to add a tax to it, in which case we're going to put the HST as the default. All of these things can be changed later. So now we're going to save this one and make another one. And maybe we'll call this you're after setting a rate per hour. Maybe we'll have a reduced rate, an assistant rate. How's that? Let's set up an assistant rate. Assistant rate. And we'll make this one be $50. Go to the services account, and let's say that this one normally has HST as well. So we're going to save and close these. I'm going to go up to our time tracking. Now, we're going to have to make sure that in our company settings, we're able to track the services against time that we bill. So we're going to go into here, account settings, and then we're going to go to advanced. Now, if we scroll down here, we have time tracking. Add a service field to timesheets, and this is what we want to do. So we want to make sure we add this here. I always change this to Monday. And save. We're done with that. We can now pop up to time tracking. So here, we select the name of the person who's carrying out this service, who's doing the work. I'm going to say it's Andrew. Andrew is doing this work for Andre, and it is the hourly rate that we set up. Here it is, the hourly service. You can see it's billed at $100. So we can say you did 5 hours of providing hourly service. This is not very descriptive, but whatever it is that you do and whatever you want to appear on the invoice. We're going to save it. Oh, interesting. I'm going to change our customer. That one's in Hong Kong dollars, so we're going to give it to Benjamin. Okay, saving you. So now we're going to be billing out the assistant's work. We'll say Celeste is our assistant, and we're going to do this to Benjamin as well, so we don't end up with that currency error. That's something I wish they'd fix in QuickBooks. And this will be our assistant rate. And the assistant was there for 5 hours also. Assisting with hourly service, whatever it is that you do. And then we will save it. And we'll go on, I'll create an invoice for Benjamin. Here we go. And you'll notice that we have the option to add this billable time right here. We're going to add it all. And here we have an invoice. So we have the hourly service, 5 hours at $100. Assistant rate, 5 hours at $50. Total bill of $750, and the HST has come on automatically. If for some reason this was a client you didn't charge HST to, or the service was for some reason not taxable, you just simply change it here. And then you can save and send that invoice to your customer.
If you have any questions or would like further help getting that set up, reach out. If this video was useful, click like below, subscribe to my channel. I've also created a small business month-end checklist to help you keep your books in order. Click the link below, download a free copy. If there's anything else you'd like help with, make a note below and my next video could be for you. Cheers.